Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh.
Good morning, dear students. In this section, you will learn about rainwater harvesting. Children, water is renewable resource. 3/4 of Earth's surface is covered with water, but only a small proportion of it accounts for fresh water fit for use. Let us discuss about some facts about water. Only 2.5% of water is fresh, and most of this are in the form of polar ice caps. Water uses has increased by 70% since from 1970. A recent report by Credited Issues stated that 2025 will be countries 18 countries will be experiences water demand beyond supply capabilities. Children, you all of you know that life is possible on the earth due to the presence of water. Nearly 3/4 of earth's surface, already we discussed that it is covered with the water. Water is also found below the earth's surface. It is present in air in the form of water vapor. About 70% of human body is also covered. In the past few years, there was not even enough rain. Everything had dried up. There was no water for drinking, for growing crops or for animals, and people even had to leave their villages and go nearby towns for some work. During dry and hot weather periods, it is common to find dry and cracked earth without even a single shed of water or wet area. Lakes, rivers and streams may also have well run dry. Well, these are the typical earth conditions that define drought. Now, let us discuss the importance of rainwater harvesting. Harvesting rainwater for saving drinking water has gained enormously in significance as modern water saving and sanitary technique. This can be used for private and public buildings as well as for many industrial areas. Due to the storage and the usage of rainwater, the water flow of housing estates in both reduced and delayed. Now let us discuss what is rainwater harvesting. Water is our most precious natural resource and something that most of us take for granted. We are now increasingly become aware of the importance of water to our survival and its limited supply, especially in such a dry continent areas like Australia. The harvesting of rainwater simply involves the collection of water from surfaces on which rain falls and subsequently storing this water for later use. Normally, water is collected from the roofs of buildings and stored in rainwater tanks. There is a very common in rural Australia. Water can also be collected in dams from rain falling on the ground and producing runoff. Methods of rainwater harvesting. Broadly, there are two ways of rainwater harvesting. First one is surface runoff harvesting and second one is rooftop rainwater harvesting. Let us discuss in detail about these two types of rainwater harvesting. Surface runoff harvesting. In urban areas, rainwater flow away as surface runoff. This runoff could be caught and be used for recharging aquifers by adopting appropriate methods. Now let us discuss about rooftop rainwater harvesting. It is a system of catching rainwater where it falls. In rooftop harvesting, the roof becomes the catchments and the rainwater is collected from the roof of the house building. It can be either be stored in a tank or diverted to artificial recharge system. This method is less expensive and very effective, and if implemented properly, it helps in augmenting the groundwater level of the area. Components of the rooftop rainwater harvesting. The illustrative design of the basic components of rooftop rainwater harvesting system is given in the typical schematic diagram. Now let us discuss the components of rooftop rainwater harvesting system. First one is catchment, second one is transportation, first flush, filter, storage, usage, recharge. These are the components of rooftop rainwater harvesting system. Now let us discuss about catchment. The surface that receives rainfall directly is the catchment of the rainwater harvesting system. It may be a terrace, courtyard, or paved or unpaved open ground. The terrace may be flat, stone roof, or sloping roof. Therefore, the catchment is the area which actually contributes rainwater to the harvesting system. Transportation. Rainwater from rooftop should be carried through down take a water pipes or drains to storage in harvesting system. Water pipe should be UV resistance of required capacity. Water from sloping roofs should be caught through gutters and down take pipe. A terrace mouth of each drain should have a wire mesh to restrict floating material. Gutters. Gutters are channels all around the edges of a sloping roof to collect and transport rainwater to the storage tank. A carefully designed and constructed gutter system is essential for any roof catchment system to operate effectively. When the gutters are too small, considerably quantities of runoff may be lost due to the overflow during storms. The size of the gutter should be according to the flow during the highest intensity rain. It is advisable to make them 10-15% over a size. Now let us discuss about first flush. The first flush is a device used to flush off the water received in the first shower. The first shower of rain needs to flush off to avoid contaminated storable or rechargeable water by the probable contaminants of the atmosphere and the catchment roof. Filter. There is always some criticism regarding rooftop rainwater harvesting since doubts are arise that rainwater may contaminate groundwater. Yes, there is a remote possible of this fear coming true if proper filter mechanism is not adopted. Storage. Harvested rainwater can be stored in subsurfaces ground water reservoir by adopting artificial recharge techniques to meet the household needs through storage in tanks. Let us see what is recharge. Structures, rainwater may be charged into the groundwater aquifers through in suitable structures like dug wells, bore wells, recharge trenches and recharge pits. Advantages of RWH. RWH system provides water at or near the point where the water is needed or used. Rainwater is relatively clean and the quality is usually acceptable for many purposes with little or even no treatment. System is independent and therefore suitable for scattered settlements. Local materials and craftsmanship can be used in constructing rainwater system. Easy in maintenance by the owners or users. Provides a water supply for buffers use in times of emergency or breakdown of public water supply systems. Now let us see the disadvantages of rainwater harvesting. Unpredictable rainwater rainfall is hard to predict and sometimes little or no rainfall can limit the supply of rainwater. It is not advisable to depend on rainwater alone for all your water needs in areas where there is a limited rainfall. Now let us discuss about some of the old traditional water storage methods. First one, jalars. Jalars are typically rectangular shaped step wells that have tied steps on three or four sides. These step wells collect the subterranean seepage of an upstream reservoir or a lake. The city of Jodhpur has 8 jalars, the oldest being the Mahamandir Jalar that dates back to 1660 AD. Now let us discuss about talab or bandi. Talabs are reservoirs that store water for household consumption and drinking purposes. They may be natural, such as the Pokharian ponds that Tikramgarh in the Bundelkhand region, or man-made, such as lakes of Bavari. Bavari are unique step wells that were once a part of ancient network of water storage in the cities of Rajasthan. The little rain that the region received would be diverted to man-made tanks through canals built on the hills outskirts of cities. Tanka. Tanka is a traditional rainwater harvesting technique indigenous to the Dart Desert region of Rajasthan. A tanka is a cylindrical paved underground pit into which water from rooftops, courtyards, or artificially prepared catchment flows. Once completely filled, the water stored in a tanka can last throughout the dry seasons, and it is sufficient for a family of 5 to 6 members. Aharpinis are a traditional flood water harvesting system indigenous to South Bihar. Ahars are reservoirs with embankments on three sides that are built at the end of diversion canals like pinis. Pinis are artificial leads of from rivers to collect water in the Ahars for irrigation in the dry months. Johars. Johars are one of the oldest system used to conserve and recharge groundwater, or small earthen check dams that capture and store rainwater. It constructed in an area with naturally high elevation on three sides. A storage pit is made by excavating the area, and excavated soil is used to create a wall on the fourth side. Kund. Kund is a saucer-shaped catchment area that gently slopes towards the central circular underground well. Its mainly purpose is to harvest rainwater for drinking. Kunds dot the sandier tracts of western Rajasthan and Gujarat. Kulhas. Kulhas are the surface water channels found in the mountain regions of Himachal Pradesh. The channels carry glacial water from rivers and streams into the fields. Bamboo drip irrigation. Bamboo drip irrigation system is an ingenious system of efficient water management that has been practiced for over 2 centuries in northern East India. The tribal farmers of the region have developed a system for irrigation in which water from perennial springs is derived to the terrestrial fields using varying sizes and shapes of bamboo pipes. Ramtek model. The Ramtek model has been named after the water harvesting structures in the town of Ramtek in Maharashtra. An intricate network of groundwater and surface water bodies. This system was constructed and maintained mostly by the Malguzars, means landowners of that region. Eri. The Eri tank system of Tamil Nadu is one of the oldest water management system in India. Still widely used in the state, Eris act as flood control system, prevent soil erosion and wastage of running off during periods of heavy rainfalls, and also recharge the groundwater. Dam. A dam is a massive structure that hold the water flow of the river through pili waves. The dam are primarily used to save water and generate hydropower. Reservoir. Reservoir is a man-made lake created by dams that holds the backwater, primarily used for storage purpose. Indira Sagar Reservoir in Madhya Pradesh is the largest reservoir in India. So, rainwater harvesting is a technique of collection and storage of rainwater into natural reservoirs or tanks, infiltration or surface water into subsurface aquifers, and one of the methods of rainwater harvesting is rooftop harvesting. Children, now let us discuss about what is water conservation. Water conservation is a practice in which people, companies and government attempt to reduce their water usage. Children, as we know that water is a limited resource, what each of us do in the world, how we live, does make a difference. As we learn the value of clean, safe water and how to scarce it truly is, we can take steps to protect it and to get it to people who lack access today. Did you know that nearly 1 billion people, mostly in the developing worlds, have no access to safe water? More than double this number, about 2.4 billion, have no access to any form of improved sanitation facilities. They could be use your help to get it. Now let us discuss some tips to save water. The majority of household water use comes from toilets, washing machines, showers, baths, faucets and leaks. But what you can do to save water is fairly simple. These 10 water saving tips will put you on the path to conserving water in your household. First one, turn off the tap while brushing your teeth. Next, turn off the tap while washing your hands and fix your leaks. Reuse your past cooking liquids and do not run the dishwasher or washing machines until it's full. Flush with less water and water outdoor plants in the early morning. Use less electricity and skip the shower from time to time. Children, finally I conclude that rainwater harvesting is a technique of collection and storage of rainwater into natural reservoirs or tanks, or the infiltration of surface water into the subsequent aquifers, and one of the methods of rainwater harvesting is rooftop harvesting. Thank you.